the Blairing Out with Eric Blair show tonight, interviewing rockers on the red carpet for the Ronnie James Dio Stand Up and Shout Cancer Fund's third annual Bowl for Ronnie event. Calico!
Hey! We love you, Ronnie. We miss you. You are literally the best guy ever. Such an inspiration.
What are you up to right now?
I'm doing a band called Beasto Blanco, and Chris is the guitar player in Beasto Blanco, Chris Latham. Beasto Blanco is named after our favorite dog. She was this big white dog named Sookie.
Really?
Yeah, Beasto Blanco. We're just getting ready to tour in December. It's going really awesome. We did a tour with this huge German band called the Borsche Uncles, and they're like the U2 of Germany. Huge arena tour. It was awesome. So yeah, just doing a new record and kicking ass.
What kind of music is it?
If you get on your motorcycle at dawn and go tearing out, it's like just what you want to hear. It's like Motorhead and Zombie, but it has more of like a southern kind of like drawl to it. It's really great. And
Budweiser meets Motorhead.
Budweiser meets Motorhead. There you go.
And you're singing.
I am singing along with Chuck Garric, who is my dad Alice's bass player for years and years.
Now, speaking of Alice, how does his Christianity, does it affect you at all or your personal life? Do you reject his Christianity or are you accepting of it?
Not at all. As a matter of fact, I am a churchgoer. So I think it's just a distinction between, you know, I don't think it informs, like, your performance. I think it's just as long as you're not hurting anybody or damaging anybody, you know, it's like it's an expression. Like, I always use Shakespeare as an example. People go, oh, Alice's shows are so bloody and disgusting and gory. But Shakespeare was bloody and there's people screwing their sisters in Shakespeare, like, and that's classic, that's amazing. So I just think that like people get all caught up in like names and labels, and the truth is we're just entertainers, you know what I mean? No matter what you believe, we're just entertainers and we love rock and roll.
Beyond being a churchgoer, have you actually made a commitment to Christ?
I have, absolutely.
How did that happen?
Well, I was brought up in a Christian home, you know, and I came to LA and I went out of my mind, lost my mind, did everything I wanted to do. And then about 5 years ago, a friend of mine says, hey, there's this church, Reality LA, you should come. And I knew the basics, you know, but I went back and I sat there and I went 2, 3, 4 times. And before I knew it, it was like, I was right back in there. And I was talking to God every day, like, and not in like a sweet little dainty Christian way, in like a way where you're like, you know what? You know what your problem is? But it was great because it was a dialogue open then. You know what I mean? And so I have a great relationship right now with God. I'm working on it. Far from perfect, but we'll see what happens.
Is that reflected in your lyrics at all in any of the new music?
Well, you know something? It's really about the blue collar people that just get up and grind every day. You know, it's not about the rock star lifestyle. It's not about any of that. It's really about like the hardworking people on planet Earth, the people that get overlooked, you know, the people that like bust their asses and just for barely a look, you know what I mean? So those are our people. So basically, like, well, whatever your belief system is, we're kind of projecting a like, let's join together, let's all like join hands together. And you're Muslim, you're Jewish, I'm Christian, but we're people, and that's what we need to focus on right now, I think.
The direction the world's going in today, are you okay with it?
I mean, I don't think anybody can be okay with it, but I think your responsibility now is to kind of plant your heels, you know, hold on tight, hold on to your family and your friends, and do the best you can, because, I mean, there's things that are so big, and, you know, ultimately we are going to have to bond together at some point, which is kind of what our band's about. You know what I mean? Like, let's overlook your preference for men or women. Let's overlook, you know, your religious preference, and let's bond together and say no more of this. We're not having any more of this. So I love you brought that up.
Would you, if forced to, take the RFID chip?
If forced?
Yes.
You can't even force me to get in my proper lane on the freeway. I think I would rather be on the street and an outcast than succumb to... If I wanted to, then I'm in. But you can't tell me. It's so un-rock and roll. You have to fill in the blank. I don't have to do anything. You have to catch me first.
Well, where can we find your music?
BeastoBlanco.com. We're on Facebook. We're on Instagram. We're everywhere.
The Blairing Out Show.